Hello everyone. So in the last video we discussed about three root locus examples. In this video lecture we'll discuss about another four more examples of root locus sketch, how to draw and how to comment on the stability. The first example, the continuation of the previous video, so this is fourth example. So for the given unity feedback system, so here the system it is given k into s plus 1 divided by s square into s plus 9. For this, draw the root locus sketch and determine the stability. Now, the first step, number of poles, number of zeros, starting point of the root locus sketch, terminal point of the root locus sketch. So here, number of poles, s square, 0, 0, 2 poles at origin, and s is equivalent to minus 9. So we have 3 poles, 0, 0, minus 9, and 0 from the numerator polynomial of open loop transfer function, which it gives zeros, where 0 it is minus 1. From the denominator polynomial we will get poles, from the numerator polynomial we will get zeros. Here number of poles are 3, number of zeros are 1. So poles are greater than zeros. This is as per rule number 2, case 1. So where poles are greater than z, number of root locus branches are, where poles are greater than zeros, number of root locus branches are equivalent to number of poles, so which is equivalent to 3. Here in this case all the root locus branches will start from open loop pole locations. What are the open loop pole locations? 0, 0 and minus 9. And out of p number of root locus branches, z number of root locus branch will terminate at 0 location. Out of p number of branches, out of 3 branches, root locus branches, one branch will terminate at 0 location. At minus 1 it will terminate. And the remaining p minus z branch, so remaining p minus z it is 2 branches. Remaining 2 branches will approach to infinity. The next step, pole zero plot. So here poles are 0, 0, minus, poles are 0, 0, minus 9. Poles are marked at origin, 2 poles, 2 cross marks are there, so which it indicates a square term, 2 zeros at origin, 2 poles, and this it is minus 9. It is minus 9. Here we have 2 poles at origin, 0, 0, and 0 it is minus 1. 0 it is minus 1. This is pole 0 plot. 0 it is marked with small circle, poles are marked with cross marks. Now, real axis root locus section we have to check. So in between this section, if we take right hand side, the total number of poles and zeros are even in count. So this is not a root locus section. From here if we take test point, let me take a test point from here. From here right to this, the total number of poles and zeros are odd in count, 1, 2, 3, odd in count. So this particular section it is real axis root locus section. Particular section it is real axis root locus section. After this, if I take a test point, after minus 9 if I take a test point and write to this, the total number of poles and zeros are 4, which is even in count, so this is not a root locus section. Only the branch which it is from section, which it is from minus 1 to minus 9, this it is real axis root locus section. Real axis root locus section. So and from here itself for breakaway point we can predict. As per general prediction we have 3 prediction. If there are adjacently placed poles, that first prediction is not coming. Second prediction, if there are adjacently placed zeros, so second prediction also not existing. The third prediction, here zero should be there next to zero. Further, if it is a real axis root locus section, then there is the possibility of occurrence of minimum one breakaway point. That is also not occurring here. So all the three predictions are not happening. So this is pole zero plot and prediction of breakaway point. As per the general prediction, there is no breakaway point. So let us move to the next step. angles of asymptotes and centroid. Angles of asymptote formula is 2q plus 1 into 180 by p minus z. So where q value it is up to p minus, q value should be up to p minus z minus 1. So till p minus z minus 1. P it is 3, z it is 1, minus 1. So 3 minus 2, 1. So q value till 2, 1. So 0 and 1. So 2 values for q. So when we substitute q value as 0, 90, q value is 1, we are getting 270. And sigma it is centroid. Real parts of poles minus real parts of zeros divided by number of poles minus number of zeros. So 2 zeros, 0, 0, then minus 9 pole real part. And minus, this minus, real parts of zeros, it is minus 1. So by substituting that, we will get centroid value as minus 4. So this is how we have to calculate centroid and angles of asymptotes. So we'll move to the next step. So here pole zero plot and asymptotic lines are drawn. Here two zeros are placed at origin and minus one pole and minus nine it is, minus one it is zero, minus nine it is pole. So here centroid from the previous step, centroid it is minus 4. So at minus 4 centroid it is kept. From here one angle it is 90 degree theta 1, the other angle it is theta 2. So asymptotic lines has to be drawn by using dotted line or by using thin line. The next step, breakaway point. As per general prediction, in this example, there is no breakaway point. But let us do the breakaway point step and then we will do it. We will check. So this example, it is special case. So only in this example, as per general prediction, there is no breakaway point, it is existing. But when we calculate the breakaway point, here we obtain there is three different breakaway points and all the three breakaway points are valid breakaway point. That is why particularly I have taken this example and explain. So characteristic equation we are finding out. How do we find out characteristic equation? 1 plus g of s into h of s, which it gives characteristic equation and equate it to 0. So in the given example, g of s into h of s it is given. So there is open loop transfer function. When we have open loop transfer function, by doing 1 plus g of s into h of s, which is equivalent to 0, we will obtain the characteristic equation. Now, after obtaining the characteristic equation, write the separate k term. So here we obtain the k term. Here we are getting u by v. When we get u by v, to do the derivation, u v du minus u dv divided by v square v du minus u dv divided by v square. So here numerator term we have to consider as u, denominator term consider as v. Then do this derivation part, we will obtain dk by ds value. So in this dk by ds, take a cube, s cube term we are getting, so we will get three different roots. Those s roots are 0, minus 3 and minus 3. Now, if you substitute this 0, minus 3 and minus 3 in the equation for k, we are getting the k value as positive. When we substitute k s value as minus 3, we are getting k as plus 27. So when we get k value as positive, then the substituted s, that means the substituted breakaway point, it is valid breakaway point. If we take 0 and then if we substitute 0, we will obtain k value as 0. Here, when we obtain k as 0, then it is considered to be a positive value. In that case, 0 also it becomes a valid breakaway point. So 0, minus 3 and minus 3. All the 3 points it becomes valid breakaway point. Next step, intersection of root locus with imaginary axis. So to do this step, we need to take characteristic equation. So here again, characteristic equation is done by using 1 plus g of s into h of s. Same characteristic equation. S cube plus 9s square plus ks plus k, which is equivalent to 0. And from the characteristic equation, form the Raoult array. So the Raoult array is formed, and from here now we have to determine the k range, k marginal, and we have to determine the auxiliary equation, and from the auxiliary equation we will find out the roots. Those roots are the intersection point where root locus will intersect the imaginary axis. In this example, first two rows cannot become row of zeros because we have constant values. Last row never it can be row of zeros. So there is a possibility of only s to the power 1 row can be row of 0. So s to the power 1 row, if we see, if we put k value as 0, then this term it becomes 0. When k is 0, in this case, when k is 0, only then s to the power 1 row it becomes row of zeros. When k is negative or when k is 0, so when k is 0, that means k marginal it is 0, only then we are getting s1 row it is row of zeros. When k marginal is 0 or when k marginal is negative, for both the cases the root locus sketch will completely lie only on the left hand side of s plane. That means the root locus sketch absolutely stable for the k value which it varies from 0 to infinity. Whenever k marginal is 0 and k or negative, the root locus sketch for the k lies between 0 to infinity. It lies completely on the left hand side of the S plane. The root locus sketch will not cross the imaginary axis. So the system it is completely absolute, this given system it is absolutely stable for the k range between 0 to infinity. Next step, angles of departure. So the given system, there is no complex pole. Three poles we got, all the three poles are real poles. When we have real poles, it is not required to find out angles of departure. No complex pole, only we have only real pole for the given example. So it is not required to calculate angles of departure. So complete root locus sketch now we are going to do a plot it. So poles are marked here. Two zeros over here. Two zeros here. Minus 9 pole and minus 1 zero. And this section, it is real axis root locus section. From the previous step we obtained it. Now what about the starting point of the root locus branches? All the root locus branches will start from open loop pole location. So minus 9 minus 9, it is one of the pole. From here where one branch it is going to start, this starting branch the branch which it is starting at minus 9, it starts from here at minus 9 and it cannot move to left to 9, minus 9, because this path is not a root locus section. It can take only the right hand side of minus 9 because this is a root locus section. So this is the direction what we have to give for this particular branch. And this branch it is approaching and terminating at this zero location. So what about the terminal point of the root locus branches? Out of P branches, Z number of branches will terminate at zero location. Z number. So out of 3 root locus branches, one branch will terminate at zero location. So this is that branch. So one branch is starting from minus 9 pole and terminating at minus 1, 0. So first branch it is done. The remaining 2 branches will start from this open loop pole locations where 2 zeros are there at origin. Now, the branch which it is starting from here, before starting the branches, will mark the breakaway points. So asymptotic lines are drawn, breakaway points at 0, here we have one breakaway point, and at minus 3, this is point at minus 3, here we have 2 breakaway point. Now, the branch 1 which it is starting from 0 location, it is 0 is also one of the breakaway point. So at this 0, this branches, the branches, 2 branches are starting. So at 0 location at origin, the root locus branches which are leaving, 2 branches are leaving from this place. So both the branches are leaving at the breakaway point 0. One is coming like this, the other one it is going in this direction. So this is the direction. This is the direction. Now, the branch it is moving forward and approaching to this breakaway point. Again, minus 3 is another breakaway point. Approaching this breakaway point and approaching to infinity by following the asymptotic line. So this is second branch it is done. Now, third branch which it is starting from the pole location 0, this is third branch which is again taking this 0 breakaway point and leaving here, approaching this another third breakaway point minus 3, then following the asymptotic line approaching to infinity. So this is the complete root locus sketch. This is a complete root locus sketch. Whatever it is drawn in the red color line, that it indicates the final root locus sketch. We'll move to the next step. So the entire root locus which it lies completely in the left hand side of S plane. So the system it is absolutely stable. We'll move to the next example. So this is fifth example. The given open loop transfer function k into s plus 12 divided by s into s square plus 16s plus 100. So we have to draw the root locus sketch and comment on the stability. Here poles from the denominator polynomial, from this quadratic equation we will get 2 poles, that is minus 8 plus or minus j6, and 1 pole at origin where s is equivalent to 0. So 3 poles we have and 1 0, that 0 it is minus 12, 0 from the numerator polynomial. Now starting point and terminal point of the root locus branches. before to that, we have to determine how many root locus branches. Here poles are 3, 0 it is 1. So P is greater than Z. In this case, P is greater than Z. So number of root locus branches are capital N. Number of root locus branches are equivalent to 3, P. Which is equivalent to P. 3 poles. Now, out of 3 all the 3 branches, the starting point it is, all the 3 branches will start from open loop pole location. The pole locations from 0, minus 8, plus J6, minus 8, minus J6. This is starting point. Now terminal point, out of 3 branches, Z number of branch will terminate at 0 location. So out of 3 branches, Z number of branch, one branch will terminate at 0 location. What is 0 location? It is minus 12. One branch will terminate at minus 12. The remaining P minus Z branches, totally 3 poles, 1, 0. So the remaining P minus Z. So remaining 2 branches will approach to infinity. This is how starting point and terminal point of root locus branches are determined. We'll move to the next step. Angles of asymptotes. So pole zero plot drawn in the graph sheet. So when we discuss about the graph sheet, I'll explain the pole zero plot. Angles of asymptotes and centroid, this we know how to calculate it, same way it is done. Angles of asymptotes and centroid point. Here let us take pole zero plot and then plot the poles are 0. So one pole it is pole is at 0. So minus 8 plus J6. So let us take here minus 8 plus J6. Minus 8 minus J6. The 0 it is at 12. Minus 12. 0 is at minus 12. So somewhere here let me take minus 12. So real axis root locus section. So let me take a test point over here. So we have to see only the real axis. So right to this, the total number of poles and zeros are 1 in count. So this particular section, whatever I am making it thick, that section it is real axis root locus section. This is real axis root locus section. Now, as per the general prediction of breakaway point, we have 3 general prediction. None of the general predictions are occurring in this example. So as per the general prediction, there is no breakaway point. So here we have given breakaway point does not exist. Only the previous example which was different, even though if we don't get general prediction, but the breakaway point it is existing. Now we will move to the next step. So in this example, we have complex pole. When we get complex pole, we need to do angles of departure. So we have 2 complex poles are there, minus 8 plus or minus J6. So first let us do it only for minus 8 plus J6. So minus 8 plus J6 it is taken as a reference. From all other poles and zeros, connect to this reference pole with a dotted line. Minus 8 plus J6 it is taken as a reference pole. From all other remaining poles and zeros, connect dotted line to this reference pole. So it is connected from 0 and from the conjugate pole minus 8 minus J6, then from this 0 minus 12 it is connected. Now the angle what it is making from the remaining poles and zeros, those angles to be measured. So this is phi p1 from the first pole, from the second pole phi p2, from the zero the angle it is phi z1. By using protractor measure these angles and then add both pole angles, then separately take zero angle, where sum of phi p it represents sum of phi p1 plus phi p2. Sum of phi p it is phi p1 plus phi p2. Phi z, phi z1 angle. So by doing that calculate phi value. After calculating phi, angle of departure phi d it is 180 minus phi. So by doing this calculate the angle of departure, which it gives 176.86. Now there is only phi value. Angle of departure it is coming around 3.1 plus 3.179. So now we have taken minus 8 plus J6 as a reference and calculated the angle of departure, which we are getting as plus 3.179. To get it for the conjugate pole, minus 8 minus J6 into minus 1 we have to do. So the angle it is minus 3.179. So now we have done with all the points. Let us plot the final sketch. So pole at 0, complex pole over here, minus 8 plus J6, minus 8 minus J6 and 0 at minus 12. So this particular section it is real axis root locus section, which we have discussed in that particular thing. Now total number of branches are 3. These 3 branches, all the 3 branches will start from these 3 pole locations, and in that one branch which it is starting from this 0, the branch which it is starting from this 0, that branch cannot go this side because this is not a root locus section, this is root locus section. That is why the direction it is given in this way, starting from this 0 location and moving to minus 12, terminating at pole location. One branch starting from 0 open loop pole location and terminating at minus 12, which it is open loop 0 location. One branch it is done. The remaining 2 branches will start from complex conjugate pole minus 8 plus J6 and minus 8 minus J6. When it starts from minus 8 plus J6, from here keep the protractor in this direction and measure plus 3.16 angle, plus 3.1 angle. So take a protractor, place it like this and measure the angle. So that angle, draw it with dotted line. The branch which it is starting from this complex pole, it should leave this angle to certain distance. Afterwards, here in this example, if we calculate intersection point, here I have not calculated, but if you calculate the root locus intersects imaginary axis, here we get k marginal value as negative. That is why the intersection point it is not happening. So take this root locus section, take this root locus branch from this complex conjugate pole, follow this plus 3.1 degree line, and this is the asymptotic line where theta 1 is 90 degree, theta 2 is 270 degree. After a certain distance, it should follow the asymptotic line. So this is 3.1 degree line. After that, follow this asymptotic line and approach to infinity. This is the direction. Approach to infinity. Second branch is done. Third branch, which it starts from minus 8, minus J6. Same way, mark this 5D angle, minus 3.1 degree. And start the branch from minus 8, minus J6. Minus 8, minus J6. Follow this minus 3.1 degree line to some extent. Then it has to follow the asymptotic line and approach to infinity. This is the direction. So whatever it is drawn with red color line, that those red color lines which it indicates root locus sketch. When you draw these lines in the graph sheet, these root locus branches should be drawn with thick line. Asymptotic lines and angles of asymptotes, asymptotic line and this departure angle line to be drawn with dotted lines or thin line. So we'll now stability. Let us comment on the stability. So the root locus sketch completely lying on the left hand side of the S plane. So no intersection point since K marginal is negative. So when the root locus sketch it completely when it is completely lying on the left hand side of S plane, the system it is absolutely stable. So for the K range 0 with respect to K when you write, for the K range 0 to infinity, because K marginal is negative, when K range 0 to negative 0 to infinity, the root locus sketch it is completely lying on the left hand side of the S plane. So the system it is absolutely stable for the K range from 0 to infinity. This is how we have to comment on the stability. Fine, let us move to the next example. So next example, this is a given open loop transfer function g of s into h of s. So four poles are there here. S is minus 3, S is minus 5 and two complex poles. Those two complex poles are minus 1 plus or minus j2. So in this case, the number of root locus branches where p is greater than z, so the number of root locus branches are 4. So the starting point, all the root locus branches will start from open loop pole location and terminate at infinity or approaching to infinity. Since there is no 0 present, no branch will terminate at 0 location. Next step, pole 0 plot. One is at minus 3, minus 5. Remaining two complex poles, minus 1 plus j2, minus 1 minus j2. When we take real axis root locus section, this will not be a root locus section. Only this is the first section what we have. So between minus 3 and minus 5, if we take a test point, write to this the total number of real pole and 0, it is 1, which is odd in count. So this particular section it is real axis root locus section. This side, if we take here, if we take a real test point, right side the total number of poles and 0 to that particular test point, it is even in count. So this section, it is not a root locus section. Only this section, it is a root locus section. And as per the general prediction of breakaway point, here it is minus 3, 1 pole, here it is minus 3, 1 pole. These two poles are adjacently placed poles, and in between these two poles, there is a real axis root locus section. Then there is a possibility of occurrence of minimum one breakaway point. We'll move to the next step. Angles of asymptotes and centroids. You know how to calculate, use that formula and calculate the angles of asymptote and centroid. Here we get four angles, 45 degree, 135 degree, 225 and 315 degree, and centroid value minus 2.5. So plot the angles of asymptotes, plot the centroid and angles of asymptotes in the graph sheet. As per the general prediction, we got the breakaway point. Since we got the breakaway point as per general prediction, let us calculate the breakaway point. Take the characteristic equation, write the equation for k, dk by ds we have to do. So s cube term we are getting, so 3 roots we will get. So in this 3 roots, one it is real root, the remaining 2 are complex roots. So real root, substitute it in the value of k, then check whether k is positive. If k is positive, then the substituted value is valid. Here we are getting k is positive, so this is valid breakaway point. For the complex conjugate breakaway point, use angle condition. So when you use angle condition, if you get odd multiples of 180, then the substituted value is valid breakaway point. So here these two are not following the angle condition, so these two complex breakaway points are invalid breakaway points. Only the real breakaway point it is valid breakaway point. So let us do intersection with imaginary axis. Write the route array, characteristic equation. From the characteristic equation, write the route array. So row of zeros, auxiliary equation, find out row of zeros and determine auxiliary equation. So from the auxiliary equation, the roots are plus or minus j 2.64, k marginal value it is 128. In the given example, we have complex pole minus 1 plus or minus 2j. By taking minus 1 plus j2 as the reference pole, let us calculate the angle of departure. So angle of departure to be calculated, by taking minus 1 plus j2 as the reference, connect all other poles and zeros. Here we don't have zeros, so connect all the poles to this reference point with the dotted line. Then calculate the angles, the remaining poles which it is making towards this reference pole. Then calculate total phi. Phi it is sum of phi p minus phi z, where phi z value it is 0, where phi sum of phi p will be addition of all these three angles. Then phi d angle departure angle will be 180 minus phi p. So put it in that phi p value, then calculate angles of departure. What we are getting here in this example, it is 18.4 at minus 1 plus j2. Then at minus 1 minus j2, the angle of departure will be minus 18.4. We'll move to the final sketch. Now, 4 poles, one it is minus 3, minus 5, complex pole, here one complex pole, here the other complex pole. Let me mark it with red pointer. Minus 3, minus 5, the complex pole. This particular section it is real axis root locus section. From this complex poles, mark this mark the asymptotic lines. So asymptotic lines are marked from the centroid. So all the four angles are marked in the form of x. By using protractor, these angles to be measured and then marked from the centroid. After that, from the breakaway point to be marked, where the breakaway point it is. What is the breakaway point? Minus 4.21. Minus 4.21 it is breakaway point. Breakaway point it is marked. From the complex pole, mark that 18 degree angle. Angle of departure. Here also from this pole it is marked 18 degree dotted line. And from this pole that 18 degree dotted line it is drawn. Now, the branches which it is starting from minus 3 and all the four root locus branches, all the root locus branches will start from open loop hole location. Let us discuss only about the first two branches, which are starting from minus 3 and minus 5. The branches which are starting from minus 3 and minus 5, the branch which is starting from minus 5 cannot go this side because this is not a root locus section which can take this direction. The branch which is starting from minus 3 cannot go this side because this is not a root locus section. It can go only towards this side because this is root locus section. That is why the direction is given in this side. Here also the direction is given this side. And these two branches meet at this breakaway point minus 4.21. The branches which it starts from minus 5 and minus 3 meets this breakaway point, and from this breakaway point it leaves at an angle of plus or minus 180 by plus or minus 180 degree by small n, where small n it indicates the number of branches which it is approaching the breakaway point. Here small n is equivalent to 2, so this angle will be plus or minus 90 degree. So at the breakaway point minus 4.91, draw a small plus or minus 90 degree line. These two branches meets this breakaway point and takes this minus plus or minus 90 degree angle to certain extent and leaves this breakaway point. Follow the asymptotic line, then approach to infinity. All the four branches are approaching to infinity. This is the direction. The other branch will leave this breakaway point and take the minus 90 degree line and follow this asymptotic line and approaches to infinity. This is the direction. So in root locus sketches, whenever we draw root locus branches, the direction is very important, from where it starts and where it approaches. Two branches are done. The remaining two branches, which it starts from complex poles, minus complex poles, that we'll discuss, minus 1 plus 2j and minus 1 minus 2j. Here the branch which it starts from minus 1 plus 2j, it takes this plus 18 degree line, and intersection point also we have to mark. Intersection point it is, this is root locus from the router we got it, root locus branch which it intersects the imaginary axis. Mark those two points. Plus J2.64 and minus J2.64. So start the branch from minus 1 plus J2, take this plus 18 degree line, follow the asymptotic curve, intersect this intersecting point, then approach to infinity. This is the direction. Now from the other side, and root locus is symmetrical about real axis, that always we have to keep it in the mind, and whatever we have drawn in this way, the same way the other side it will come. So now we are going to see the branch which is starting from minus 1 minus J2. Start from here, follow that minus 18 degree line to certain extent, then follow the asymptotic line, intersect this intersecting point, then approach to infinity. This is the direction. So whatever I have done it with red color line, when you draw it, make it thick, and this red color line, it gives the final root locus sketch. So when we comment about the stability, K marginal we have got 128, and here C So lesser than 128, the system it is, it lies completely on the left hand side, the system it is stable. At k marginal, 128, system it is marginally stable. When k is greater than 128, the system it is unstable. Let us see the next example. Here, a simple closed loop transfer function block diagram it is given, negative feedback loop. Generally, when we draw whatever the root locus sketch we are drawing it for open loop transfer function. So from the given block diagram, we have to take only the open loop transfer function. The open loop transfer function from the forward path. So the transfer function will be k into open loop transfer function g of s into h of s s plus 2 into s plus 3. Those two blocks are in cascade, so just multiply the gain values s into s plus 1. So this is open loop transfer function, whatever I have written, which gives open loop transfer function. Now for this open loop transfer function only, we have to draw the root locus sketch. Now poles are minus 2, what are the poles here? Poles from the denominator polynomial, 0 and minus 1. The zeros are minus 2 and minus 3. Here the beauty it is, number of poles are equivalent to number of zeros. So the root locus branches are equivalent to number of poles, which are equivalent to number of zeros. Starting point and terminal point, when P is equivalent to Z, this it comes under case 3 as per rule number 2. All the root locus branches will start from open loop pole location and terminate at zero location. So starting point, open loop pole location 0, minus 1, and terminal point, open loop zeros minus 2 and minus 3. Let us move to the next step. Pole 0 plot. Poles are 0, minus 1. This is 0. This is minus 1. Zeros are minus 2, minus 3. Minus 2, minus 3. Real axis sigma, imaginary axis j omega. So pole 0 plot it is done. Now let us draw the real axis root locus section. This section, this real axis root locus section, right side is odd and count. This is not a root locus section. Again, this is root locus section. Now let us do the general prediction about breakaway point. There is a possibility of, here there are adjacently placed two poles and in between that section it is a root locus section. Then here there is a possibility of minimum one breakaway point. And here there are two adjacently placed poles. In between that section it is real axis root locus section. Here again there is a possibility of occurrence of minimum one breakaway point. Here between poles and between zeros, so between zeros that point it is called as break-in point. When we draw the final sketch, let me explain why it is called as break-in point. So here there is a possibility of breakaway point. Between poles there is a possibility of break-in point. Let us move to the next step. Yes, the next step it is asymptotic lines. So what is the formula to calculate angles of asymptotes or centroids. Centroid it is sigma. The denominator term will be p minus z. To calculate angles of asymptotes, 2q plus 1 into 180 degree divided by capital P minus capital Z. In both the cases, in centroid as well as in angles of asymptote, the denominator it is capital P minus Z. In this example, the number of poles are equivalent to number of zeros. So centroid and asymptotic lines will be infinity, so that case will not exist. So whenever poles are equivalent to zeros, there is no asymptotic lines. We'll move to the next step. Breakaway point. We have to calculate the characteristic equation 1 plus g of s into h of s. So we have taken only the k equation. Again here u by v formula, where in the previous example whatever we have discussed the same way. When we have u by v formula, v into du minus u into dv by v square. Numerator term it is u, denominator term v. By doing this we will obtain dk by ds. When we obtain dk by ds, here you can multiply and write it for the simplification. The numerator term, so here if you take s square plus s divided by s square plus 5s plus 6. So when you put it by u by v formula, then this will become simple. See, v it is kept as it is. First term v, s plus 2, s plus 3. Du term it is 2s plus 1. 2s plus 1 minus u. U is s into s plus 1. S into s plus 1 into dv. Dv term is denominator 1. So 2s plus 5. 2s plus 5 divided by v square. So do that and then calculate the s values, where here s values are, 2 s values are getting. Check it for the validity by putting it in k value. So for both the breakaway points, k it becomes positive, so both are valid breakaway points. So this actually you can cross check. This point it is lying between one point will lie between 0 to minus 1, the other point will lie between minus 2 to minus 3. One point it is lying between 0 to minus 1, the other point is lying between minus 2 to minus 3. So these two are valid breakaway points. Next step. Now the final sketch. And here in this example, in this given example, we don't have complex poles. When we don't have complex pole, there is no point of calculating angles of departure. And if you calculate root locus, intersection of root locus with imaginary axis, in this example also we will get k marginal value as negative. Please calculate and check it. You will get k marginal value as negative. When k marginal is negative, the root locus sketch will not intersect the imaginary axis. It lies completely on the left hand side of S plane. So the final sketch, this is one pole, 0, minus 1, and zeros are minus 2, minus 3. This is one pole, 0, minus 1, this is 0, minus 2, minus 3. This is one breakaway point. Between pole, I said that is break in point. This is another point which it is breakaway point. Now, as per rule number 2, two branches are the root locus branches. Both the branches will start from open loop pole location. One it is starting from open loop pole location 0, the other one it is starting at open loop pole location minus 1. The branches which are starting from these two points cannot go this side because this is not a root locus section, cannot go this side because this is not a root locus section. It can take only these two sides. And which it takes these two sides at this breakaway point, again here at this breakaway point, which it leaves the breakaway point at an angle of plus or minus 180 by small n, again that is 90 degree, and this is the direction. And here this point, it is approach where it these two branches should terminate. These two branches should terminate at zero location. So that is why this point is called as in point. These two branches coming into this point, break in point. Again this angle it is plus or minus 180 by small n, 90 degree, and one branch it terminates at zero location. The second branch again it starts from here, leaving this breakaway point at an angle of 90, and at this break in point it approaches in and terminates at this zero location. This I will draw and show it. So this is real axis root locus section between two poles. This is real axis root locus section. The branch which it is starting from zero location, it comes this direction. The branch which it is starting from minus 1, it approaches this direction. And at this point the angle which the branches leaves this breakaway point or break-in point, it is plus or minus 180 degree divided by small n, leaves this breakaway point. So this is the direction and approaches this break-in point. Approaches this break-in point. Again, this is the direction. Terminate at this zero location. This is the direction. Now the other branch which it is starting from minus 1 leaves this breakaway point. This is the direction. At this break-in point it approaches and terminate at minus 2 zero location. This is the direction. Whatever drawn in red color sketch, that it gives a final root locus sketch. Now what about the stability? The root locus sketch, it completely lies on the left hand side of S plane. For the k range 0 to infinity, the system it is absolutely stable. This is the final root locus sketch. So in this drawn sketch, direction is not given. Like this we should not draw. Direction should be given for the root locus branches, which it indicates from where root locus branches should start and where it should terminate. So we have to comment about the stability. The system it is absolutely stable. For the k range lies between 0 to infinity. So thank you all. With this I am completing the root locus topic.